Welcome to Operator Network. This tutorial will teach you how to read and understand a load chart. Every crane that is built to meet ASME B30.5 is required to have a load chart, which specifies the crane's capabilities. It goes into great detail describing the features and how its lift capacity varies when considering distances and angles. Failing to consult a crane's load chart before making a pick can result in some very dangerous scenarios. Just take a look at some of these videos and you'll understand. Standard equipment for the Manitex boom truck discusses all components in standard equipment. It gives you a basic overview of what this piece of equipment is equipped with. Number two, the specifications and features. In this section of the load chart that is very specific to understanding the crane's capacities and its limitations. Number three, the range diagram. On this range diagram, to the left-hand side in the vertical column, you will see a height above ground in feet section. This has a series of arcs that correlate with the lower section of the range diagram. The lower section on the horizontal plane is the operating radius. This is measured from the center line of rotation. Be sure to note the warning label from 0 to 32 degrees. Number 4, area of operation. This diagram provides a bird's eye view of the rotation and its capacities. Number 5, weights. This represents the components on the crane and what they weigh. This also determines the route to take and what is required to get it to the job. Be sure to understand what your crane weighs. Number 6, deductions. Components that influence the calculations for lifting capacity. The deduction section of this load chart is extremely important when calculating the lifting capacity of your crane. Understanding what to deduct from the crane's gross capacity, and you'll be able to reference these weights when calculating the net lifting capacity of the crane. Be sure to read this and understand the deductions very carefully. Number 7, allowable line pull. This section discusses what you can pick with different parts of line and the breaking strength for each configuration. Dimensions and weight. The chart shows the crane dimensions. It includes data for operation with the outriggers extended, transport weight, and steering dimensions. Knowledge of this information is especially critical if the crane will be working in confined spaces, as the lifting capacity varies depending on whether the outriggers are extended or not. Understanding the load chart's information. On the left-hand side of your screen, you'll notice that there is a vertical column that represents the operating radius. This is measured in feet. The operating radius is the distance from the center of rotation to the suspended cable. On the very top of your load chart, you'll see the load ratings measured in pounds with outriggers and stabilizers extended. The first portion of this diagram represents the load ratings without the jibs extended. Right next to the boom length is the loaded boom angle. The boom lengths are indicated in five sections: 26, 38, 48, 58, and 68 foot. By referencing this load chart, you'll notice that with the length of your boom and the operating radius, you will be able to identify the load ratings as well as the angle for the boom. Pay close attention to the deductions for the stowed jib. This is represented at the bottom of the load chart. Be sure to know that there is a difference between stowed and stored. Stored is where the actual jib is on the ground, detached from the boom. Stowed means that the jib is actually attached to the boom. The second half of the load chart includes the jib load ratings without riggers and stabilizers extended. Here, you'll notice that there is an operating radius measured in feet as well as the loaded boom angle. The two jibs are measured in 23 foot and 40 foot sections. If you notice, there is a black line that runs across the load chart. It kind of looks like a few steps. This line distinguishes the structural versus stability factor. Do not under any circumstances breach the structural representation. The next section of the load chart includes the warnings. This warning section is extremely important. Be very sure to read through this thoroughly and fully understand what it has to say. If in doubt, read it again.